9.4 inches. That is the official tally from our February snowstorm.
The National Weather Service measures that at the airport. But if you stuck a tape measure in the snow this morning, there's a pretty good chance that you would find something different. Wind can throw those numbers way off. Ken from Fridley and John from Jeffers want to know, how is snowfall officially measured? Good question. Heather Brown's taking a look. Heather, on one part of our roof, it looks like we had an inch. On another part, it looks like we had 3 feet.
Right. I mean, staying next to me, I mean, I think it goes up to mid-thigh around here. The winds were so fierce last night, it was blowing all over the place. Clearly not an accurate measure of the snow that we got, but the National Weather Service needs that accurate snowfall total. It gives them better flood forecasts. It also, over time, lets cities and counties and states figure out the infrastructure they're going to need for our snow and what kind of snow removal equipment they would need throughout the winters.
So how much snow did you get?
Maybe about 10.
10 inches?
About 10, 11 inches.
How do you know that?
I don't, because that's what you guys said in the news yesterday.
Nobody went out there with a ruler?
No. Are you crazy?
Good point. Fortunately for us, the folks at the National Weather Service like trudging through the snow.
This is our snowboard where we take official snowfall measurements. Mm-hmm.
It's a plain white board.
So it reflects the sunlight.
There are two out here in Chanhassen and another at the airport.
And allows the snow to stay on the board and not melt.
Every 6 hours, a meteorologist sticks a ruler in the snow that's fallen.
And we'll just put it around the board and take average measurement.
Then they wipe the board clean.
So they've been using a ruler?
Yep.
Wow.
Why doesn't the snow just blow off this thing?
Right, during windy events, that is a challenge. So we have a couple other ways that we can take snow measurements. Mm-hmm. One of them is to take an average of the snow depth in our backyard and see how it's changed in the last 6 hours. Mm-hmm.
There are three of those rulers on site.
So this is the rain gauge in the summer and the snow gauge in the winter.
Yep, exactly. The snow will fall in here and then we take it inside and let it melt. And then we pour it into our funnel and inner tube to get the liquid amount.
Really?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That is crazy.
I know. They've been doing the same thing for 70 years. Yes, exactly. The snowboard method has been tried and true.
And still haven't changed it.
No. You know, why would you fix what's not broken?
That's true.
And as for why you might get those higher measurements at your home, our expert says a lot of people take their measurements in their backyard. And believe it or not, just that inch or two of grass, depending on how short you cut it before the snow fell, that can add an inch or two to your measurements. And here's another little story. The Washington Post reported that the folks in D.C., they actually lost their snow measuring equipment in that last blizzard.
Oh, boy.
Which tells you, yeah, how hard it is when it's so windy and that much snow.
It got buried, like they lost it that way.
Absolutely. Wow. You couldn't find it, yeah.
No, they don't use it very often, so.
No.
All right.
True. All right. Thank you, Heather.
Good to see you, Heather. Here's